streaming. No, don't ask a question. Go. Pop out chat. Connecting stream software. Is everything working correctly? Let me check out on YouTube. Why is it named Da? Edit video, it should not be called Da. DD Butchers Circus Old Man Screams at Dog. That's what it was supposed to be called, but I guess that was lost in translation or something. What's chat say? Oh, that's stellar. Apparently the new YouTube thing doesn't fucking work. Oh, hell yeah. Let me switch to the old setup. Yeah, the live dashboard. It's gonna scream at me for, not setting up my, what children can watch, and I'll burn my eyes on this bright white screen, but, pop out chat, minimize. That too, that don't need OBS up. So here, da, da.
The preferred is flunged.
Yes, yes, welcome to Pain and Fucking Misery Simulator. Okay, so I've got a team that I like. So, first off, Banner. Really simple. It's based off of the King in Yellow, Aster, which is honestly pretty easy to pull off because already the Collector is based off of Aster and you get their coat. So the rest of it is just kind of making it look like a scarecrow or some shit. And here, my current team is completely adverse to those damn stress teams. Abominations up front, kind of focused on transformation. I mostly use Slam to get rid of characters like the Crusader, the Leper, and the... what's this guy's name? Flagellant. Besides that, Rage and Rake, basic damage. Usually probably going to use Rage to hit rank 3s. Rake otherwise, I'm just trying to spread bleed with the Shattered Padlock. And the Ring Eye Talisman is... I really couldn't. I knew I need accuracy to make the movement build good. Two Jesters, two Abominations only meta. Well, unfortunately, you can't actually stack characters in this mode. You can stack two Arbalest though, since there's the Arbalest and the Musketeer. That's it. This guy's literally just stun asshole. He stuns people. And if he gets moved out, I can correct with Holy Lance. The rest is just clearing up stress and healing. This is my killer. He also has move. The Grappling Mitts is just a better net. And also had stun and daze, but I don't care about that. 5% extra move chance and 4 extra accuracy. Nothing I'm gonna complain about. And the finisher, if anybody hits Death's Door, which usually I'm gunning for, just like instantly kill, yeah, I'll use the finisher and either psych people out and force them to use up turns healing and stuff. And if they don't waste turns trying to protect them, then well, finish him is 50% death blow. This is another 25% death blow, and most characters are locked at start at 75% death blow chance, so this is pretty much a one-hit kill on, or well, it's pretty much an insta-death on death's door unless they've stacked up death blow. But even then, they'll only have something like 15% ability to survive. Post-only party is kind of interesting, but I think it allows stress characters to... It depends. It's a bit of a hit or miss, though. With the Arbalest, I don't know what to do with her, really. She's just there to... make profit off of Come Hither. Oh, wait. Oh, I can't use Uppercut. I forgot this is only usable up two. And I have these two. Alright. Come. Finish him. And I guess I'll go with Flashbang then. Finish him, Come Hither, Flashbang, and then Caltrops. Come Hither, pulls two, and adds a mark. I don't like using these mark skills unless I'm looking for their debuffs, because usually it kind of feels like a waste of a turn, and it doesn't significantly disrupt the team. But Come Hither will fuck up... placement. You know, the backliner you want to kill is now up in two, and now they can be stunned by the Crusader, bullied by the Abomination, anything. And with the mark, if I pulled a fourth liner to number two, then the Arbalest can capitalize on the mark. I usually don't focus on... I don't use Collect Bounty, because if I'm marking, I want to do it with the Arbalest. This guy's here to disrupt and then sneak out a kill with either Finish Him or Caltrops. Caltrops is there if a target is stealthed or guarded. I can try and pull out an extra death blow using that, and the practically permanent bleed is okay too. Plus 5 stress taken. Kind of pointless. Doesn't do anything. And this is just attacks. Has some support moves. Illuminating Flare is there to counter the Man-at-Arms Scream attack, which is miserable. And also some stuff like Clearing Marks. Alright. Now that you know what I'm pulling here, this is essentially the anti-stress kind of go-for-easy-kills thing. I want to show you how it goes. The Ring Master demands a challenger. That was quick.
The rabble thrills to the spilling of blood.
Oh yeah, the match I did to practice before this was my last apprentice match. Now I think I'm veteran. Or whatever blue means. That's first, which means thing. I get a dodge buff, which is nice.
Unsheathe the old blade.
Proven stress. Killer. Alright, so they're going for a highly murderous approach. Very high damage, high stress.
Is flummoxed.
Ladies are moving. Hail. Alright. Don't really care about that, so immediately, I'm not gonna waste any time or let them set up. I am going to pull the Occultist. Now he's marked. And so, he's immediately in danger of my Crusader and my Arbalest. Arbalest can knock him down in just one shot. The Crusader will stun him so he can't heal. I have the snuff box for that, but... where I can correct this. This is why I equipped Holy Lance recently. Yeah, let's just go there. It really does stress parties. It's not the meta because it's a timer game. I don't know what the upper meta is, but I see tons and tons of stress teams. So clearly it's popular for a reason. That's because it takes forever to save something.
Injury. Palpable fear.
That was bad, but... You know what? I'm going to push the Highwayman back so he can't... He won't be able to use, what's it called? Point blank shot. And it also brings the occultist back over here so he can't use abyssal artillery. If he decides to duelist up, then I can just... I'll use sniper shot. Well.
The buffoon is flummoxed.
Yeah, that's an issue because either a lot of characters here can just get the kill on the abomination now, so be safe, don't be greedy. Not what I wanted to do. I really want to get down that occultist, but. Oh yeah, point blank shot isn't amazing. Oh, for fuck's sake.
The abyss.
That's obnoxious.
Returns even the boldest gaze.
Alright.
Act now.
Yeah, just get rid of the grave robber. The funny thing about point blank is that it's extra death blow, which, since it can only be used on front rank and requires him to be up front, it's kind of useless. It's dumb. Not good.
Teetering on the brink. Facing
yeah, they're
the
trying
abyss.
To set up for a kill. I'm gonna scare them. If this Holy Lance hits, well, can also heal. Nah, I'm gonna Holy Lance the Grave Robber, and if they don't heal, then they are in a precarious situation, because I can use, Come Hither and strike the Grave Robber with it. What are you gonna do? Cool. Oh, wow. That, genuinely was not expecting that. Let's take our time. We aren't in any danger right now, and we can get a kill later. Good thing is that a lot of the people you're up against have low HP. Yeah, that is nice. Although, frontliners don't scare me either. It's kind of what the abomination is here for, to make them useless. Man. Those lucky moves are so annoying. I'm fairly sure it's a 50 chance for that to be occurring, so that's obnoxious. I don't want to use Caltrops because I don't want to trigger a Highwayman riposte. He has 3 crit and stuff like that. Yeah, this snuff isn't doing what I really need it to be doing. Shadow Fade. If I could use Illuminating Flare, that would be great. For now.
Act now.
Don't want to use up our heals yet. I'm gonna pull up our Arbalest one and strike. And get the fuck out of here. Oh. Eh. It's not the worst. I wasn't really looking to push anyone in specific. I just wanted to get her up. The constant bullying of the Arbalest is really annoying. Although if she pulls right now, she'll be stuck up in front, which is good.
A hand's breadth from becoming unwound.
You can only use Duelist to try and grab the gacha. You know what? I'm gonna force him to try and heal this turn by threatening the Grave Robber by pulling this. So now the Grave Robber is just exposed, and with my Bounty Hunter up, she has to heal to prevent a finish him from taking her out. Yeah. Stop her from being able to do a lunge, so she can only shadow fade again, or use pick to the face if she's that kind of person. So you're gonna duelist to him? It's the only thing that makes sense. Lucky. Just lucky. They'll have the next turn, so... yeah, that's nice. Drop frames, that means the stream's going good. Glad to hear. Hey, let me link my stream to a friend. That's not a link. YouTube, what the fuck is that link? Oh, well, I'll fix that later. I'm gonna use this next move to just get her out of dodge. Also because this is about to stress her out, I need to remove that horror, so my next Crusader's move is going to be Inspiring Cry. Decrease stress, clear horror, and we can stop her at least now from going insane. But if the occultist presses the advantage to... yeah, this is what I think he's doing. Yeah. He's gonna scare her.
Gnawing uncertainty, the birthplace of dread.
Gonna use this turn and use Rake to get her down to death's door.
As life ebbs,
and if they don't interfere, then this bounty hunter has the kill. Shadow Fade? Yeah. And you know what? Doing that?
Act now.
We're gonna start bullying the occultist again. That goes down next turn. If that riposte lets up, I'll just use one of the, I'll probably start with them. That's
and now
annoying.
The true test. Hold fast or expire.
Affliction just kicks them out from this. Yeah. And as usual, protect her. Daze means he won't be able to heal himself, but at the same time, I'm willing to take it. Let's see, what does she do? If you lunge for him, that's... yeah.
More
I want to call that opportunistic.
The soil, feeding the evil therein.
Because we can just make a trade
right
out of that.
On, the mob rallies.
Fuck.
To the underdog.
Never mind. This is... plus 20 accuracy versus HP below 40%. That was just really unlucky.
Oh! Yes!
First off, no healing. No, I could try and get the death blow, but I'm not that scared right now. I'm gonna trigger the death blow. Well, trigger a death store check with the Arbalest. I just don't want them to heal. Yes, I just learned that voice. Get used to it. Pierce. Okay. Don't care. Fucking. That's really obnoxious, but... Oh wait, we go first next turn, so we'll have another chance to get the kill. She's gonna be put on death's door, but we do have two heals to deal with that. Yes, hello, Gamer Gazette. I'm reading. Kill. Oh, we can't even kill. Fuck. Demands its portion. Yeah, I misread that. I thought she was still in tier 3. Alright, that's not good. Because now either of these are gonna try and go for the death blow. She's doing the shield breaker, which has less of a chance to do so. Sure. Use puncture. Thank fuck that didn't work. Yeah, we have to worry about the highwayman. Heal yourself. Here, I'm gonna go to my channel and just grab this link. Send that to my friend. What happened? Who cares?
Back now.
Feeling another annoying. I usually don't have that much issue with stun, or well, hitting people. This is just really, really unlucky. Although he doesn't have any accuracy trinkets, it's fair. She doesn't either. Yeah, this has gone awry just because we missed a couple of things that would have been really opportunistic. Yeah, it's kind of a dodge comp. It's a very lazy dodge comp. It's really nothing special. Deathblow versus Marked. Really? Yeah, Stygian's Embrace is the right idea. She doesn't get any of stress dealt. Great. We need. Get out. I don't want to deal with her disruption right now. If the highwayman wants to pick a kill, well, go for it. Oh, she's going. Sure, I guess.
This is no place for the weak or foolhardy. Fight on. The mob rallies to the underdog.
Extra damage to stun, so let's try and get rid of another supportive core. Healing. I'm feeling now's a good time for Caltrops. Now I know I'm just gonna miss everything and probably gonna get immediately crit by the highwayman, but I think trying for a double kill here, the finisher, would make it a 50-50 on each. Assuming I don't miss. Scary. Oh, I can't use Caltrops. It's... I have to be one forward, so,
Confidence surges as the enemy
sure.
crumbles.
It removes their healing, which is something. But now I have to survive two death's door checks, one of which coming from the finisher, or well, the grave robber with the finisher, probably picked to the face if she's smart.
Survival yep. is a tenuous proposition in this sprawling tomb. In the end, we all die alone.
She's trying to stay out of our range and increase our crits. This is not going to,
The mob rallies to the underdog.
Be a success, but the only thing we have left to do is try and work out extra kills for points. And it's entirely possible that we can get a kill on this grave robber. So, it's the only thing we can do. Unless they try to push her to the back by both doing Duelist Advance and then they do Pierce. That'd be smart. The last hero standing barely helps. It's kind of just there as a consolation prize. Okay, no. Well, hope that my next stunning blow will work. Nope. But it still stuns, because I have really jacked up stun. Probably Pierce is the best thing for them to do.
Well, 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 it would appear the buffoon is flummoxed.
Yeah. They know what they're doing now. So, oh wait, they're both on death's door, so, something. I'm being annoying. Good. Oh yeah, they're gonna put me on Death Star and then follow up with a lunch. Yeah, this is DD. Seems like a good 50 chance. Okay. Well, this is why you don't give up. You
life wasted
have
in the pursuit
a slight chance to get one extra point. Fuck. I'm not gonna give them it.
You deny the rabble their sport and fuel their frustration. Mop the blood and collect the teeth. Will you muster the metal to return? The ringmaster is pleased.
Cultists only. Okay, if you really want to use the occultist for damage. I see that the idea is combining abyssal artillery with your little mark skill. Nothing I'd use though. Gonna go in with the same
the
setup.
Master demands a challenger.
So two weaknesses here is our lack of accuracy trinkets and well, against characters with that are stacked up with movement skills, even our Arbalest is still gonna get moved around. But it still encourages a risky play and it fails sometimes. So I think it's nice to keep it on so it's not a surefire
the
rabble choice.
Spills to the spilling of blood. Test begins.
check. No drop frames, that's good. So, melee Vestal, that's interesting. Stress healer, dodge, virtue. Yeah, this seems like some kind of weird anti-stress team, but I don't do stress. Don't know what they're doing with the brass bulge, but I'm sure it's something cool. Yeah, let's go for it. No amount of dodge can stop me, fucker. There's no extra accuracy in Mark. It's unfortunate. Honestly, I'd prefer that over damage. 10 plus accuracy, range skills like against a Mark or something. Highly preferred. Yeah, that's fair. Anything to stun, so just immediately go for anti-damage. Oof. Yeah, that's kinda sucks. Also gonna want to use the abomination when I can to. Yeah, I'd want to stun the Vestal so they can't stun the bounty hunter, so we can actually get our kill. This also seems like a team with really high restoration. That's what I'm getting from this. Just a hyper tank because they just can like infinitely heal. Protect me. That makes sense. For the Crusader immediately, but I know that if they drop to Death's Door, then the Vestal will either stun or heal. So, alright, that's the target I was least afraid of, because I'm going to stun you with him. Alright, so I think I have a kill here. Fascinating. Let's hope this is a crit. Fuck. Let's hope this pulls them forward. And I just want to decrease their dodge. It was resisted. Extra damp. Sure. Can't say I terribly care, but alright. Please. That's 110 accuracy. Welcome to Blinder Suddenly Gets Fucked by Dodge, the stream. So I've never actually had an issue with dodge teams. This is like really out of nowhere. Alright, so if I'm gonna wanna fuck over anyone from here. Okay, that's pretty good. Don't care about buckshot, so works for me. try and kill her. Yeah, I don't care. Gonna use this turn to move the Crusader all the way back.
Festering fear consumes the mind.
Oh, they do have extra move resist. I read the 20 move on the Vestal and got confused. Yeah, let's get the Vestal out of here. Okay, so now I know what I want to do. They're probably going to use her and then use the healing skill, patch up. You know, to proc the automatic rejuvenation. He's just relegated to a healer unless he wastes a turn moving. I like that play. Yeah, stack the healing. Doesn't matter too much. Gonna further stress out the team by using Finish Him on the Vestal, which deals extra damage against stun. Get them all a bit, low. Well, the Vestal can't use Divine Comfort and stuff like that. You know what? Heal him. Since nobody up here can really damage him, which seems good to prevent a wild crit from hurting us too much. Use this to immediately attack the Vestal. Right, I can't hit them. Fair enough. Again, try and scare the Musketeer. So, good thing. If the Antiquarian later uses Protect Me,
the
Antiquarian uses Protect Me. Fortunately, the little slam move breaks through that.
Act now.
Let's try and set up a kill.
Teetering on the brink, facing the abyss.
I am not afraid of losing a character to the Crusader, but even if that's fine. Wow. Well.
A hand's breadth from becoming unwound.
Festering? Yeah, festering vapors. Abomination just becomes a stunner, I guess. Manticles. Gonna heal again, mate? Another thing I'd want to do is, stun him so he can't heal. because the rest are indirect. Actually, if I kill the or knock down the musketeer now, there's no way they'd be able to heal because their turn's used. They can't use the rejuvenation. Yeah, I think this is our advantage. She's probably gonna go for another. Okay, cool. Who cares? It's a melee Vestal Knight.
A decisive pummeling.
This is probably it for her. String, don't care.
Press this advantage. Give them no quarter.
So now, effectively, we have four turns and they have three. If we can press this momentum, then we can burst down their healing and just stop them in their tracks. I know what you're trying to do with the Vestal, and I'm going to stop your cute little strategy right there. I will say it is very brazen that you're trying to do that, but at the same time, I like ruining people's lives like that.
Blow to body and brain.
Interesting, Kray. So what I'm noticing is this team lacks damage. I think that's what we're planning on, Eh, fuck it. Not great. I think that's what... That was really good. But, I think, Yeah, it lacks damage, and they're trying to use the Vestal to make up for it, along with their heal. They're kind of disrupted, so they're just trying to fight. Which I still don't care about. You know what? I'm gonna focus on the Antiquarian next, so I'm gonna stun the Crusader, so he can't get in our way. And then use the pull skill at the Bounty Hunter and try... 55. And try hopelessly to try and sniper... Okay. You know, I was kind of having fun. You know, I was trying to strategize. But, you say so, Darkest Dungeon.
Let's do it again.
The Ringmaster demands a challenger. The rabble thrills to the spilling of blood.
That's annoying. How do you have stunner, light? Seems like a light slash stun team. Yeah, I think out of everyone here, this Vestal needs to die because their stuns are strong and can hit more than the Crusader can. Even still, my next action is probably going to be using the Abomination to slam him forwards. Just completely disrupt him if I can. Does have the move resist, but it's worth going for. That's annoying. Now he's up at third, so he did it for me. And they pushed the Vestal into range for a sniper shot. Another weird... Why would you use Hand of Light? Okay. Sure. Lance, it's a damage skill, don't care.
the mind. The reveling throne demands its portion.
Also a team of a lot of healing. Crusader, Vestal, Plague Doctor with Battlefield Medicine. It's gonna be hard to get death blows without absolutely everybody, without absolutely everybody being able to prevent one. That's annoying. Heal himself.
The reveling throne demands its portion.
Let's keep scaring her if we can. Don't care too much about the Plague Doctor. They're going to be annoying, but my real threats right now are the two stunners. They're the ones I want to kill. It's probably going to use, yeah. I want to disrupt her healing entirely. Healing and stunning. So now at rank 1, there's no real easy correction to be done, so it's good.
Well.
If they don't move, I'm going to use Stunning Blow on the Vestal and make it even harder for them to correct. Hopefully NG isn't actually watching the stream, so immediately announcing my strategies probably isn't good. Just blast. Oh, that's
entering on the brink.
Those crits are really bad. Take the risk. Going to try and stress relief. If I get killed for that, then well, fucking rip. Oh, death blow chance to melee skills. That ain't good. You gonna use panic darts or pick to the? Okay. Sure. Well, I wasted her turn. That's something. Oh, they go first. Great.
This is no place for the weak or
good.
A foolhardy.
And try and go for the scare.
A hand's breadth from becoming unwound.
We can, have the stunner pick and then take a healer. That would be nice. He's probably gonna heal. Yeah.
Death is patient. It will wait. Decisive pummeling.
Yeah, just did that to put extra stress onto. Yeah, just generally stress people out. And, otherwise, it was just. No matter what, the Vestal isn't going to die, so what else can I pull? Probably should be a lot safer when it comes to healing, though. Relying on Deathblow, well, it's... When I find numbers can be fucking deceiving. Have the rake damage bonus. Just don't know how much. 10 to 19. 9, 9. Yeah, I think a rake would put them both into Death's Door, which would add a fear factor. Plus, it would be extra stress. That's good. If the game could stop.
Oh. Resolve is broken. You have won.
Alright. I can only imagine if they crashed.
Delight. Praise well earned.
Alright then. Exciting stream.
Watch people give up and then die. Do one more and just observe how well we do. Find out there's some kind of major flaw in this team that I'm not immediately noticing, and that's something that if I can rectify it, I should. I just hope it doesn't turn out that it's something that like would be solved if I had some of the later trinkets. That would be annoying. Stress team. What? Light. This guy also uses, come hither. So of all these people,
the contest begins.
I want to get rid of the Houndmaster. Houndmaster is damage and stress. 95% chance. Get him up to first rank. We'd probably also use the Abomination to hit a Manticles. Stress nuke. Prevent him from moving anyone. Oh, for fuck's sake. Actually, that makes sense. 50% stun. Annoying, but makes sense. The stealth or stress dealt. Eh. Plus 25% stress taken, negative 25 stress dealt. So that will negate the gladiator. Oh, that just isn't a stress. I thought this was the other prot item. Okay. Still.
Unnerved.
That hurts.
Unbalanced.
Waste of Caltrops, so I'm fine with that.
Palpable fear.
Pull a cultist, so the this guy's back here. So he can't continue hacking, whacking, and smacking away on the Abomination or Crusader. Plus now he's in range for the Harbalist to kill. Not kill, but... Heh. Oh, they... Okay. I'm gonna use this turn to once again try and stun the Houndmaster. Fuck. That was really unlucky. 40% stun, 20... So that was a 20% chance to not actually get it.
Dizzying blow to body and brain.
Hey. Don't be greedy. Just heal. So it gets rid of the debuffs, which is nice. A tough one. Oh, wait.
The abyss.
Oh, no, I can't hit him.
Even the boldest.
Get the fuck out. So that was a weird move, but the idea is that Arbalest and then Bounty Hunter. Obvious. Genuinely starting to think that I should replace the Quarrel. Though the armor piercing is really nice. I need the snuff. The snuff makes sure that this character is viable whatsoever. No. Care if that works.
And now,
okay.
The true test. Hold fast or expire.
Entourage, just pure damage.
A hand's breadth from becoming unwound. As life ebbs,
see what this
terrible
does.
Vistas of emptiness.
Stygian's embrace.
Themselves.
If they do, I will go for Caltrops. Try and irk out that kill. No wait, weird destruction. Oh, it is destruction. Not embrace.
But my fern is clearly flummoxed.
Fuck your dodge. Oh wait, he has finished him.
More blood soaks the soil, feeding the evil there.
Ice.
Seems like a defeat, personally, but okay, that's pretty nice. Thank you. Cultist is vulnerable again, but I don't think that matters too much right now. He can heal, so there's no point in playing Houndmaster. It's either him or the occultist, and just Bounty Hunter was on the lowest health. So I want to bait him to heal one of the two, so I can try and something. It wasn't great.
Teetering on the brink, facing the abyss. Injury and despondence set the stage for
heroism. Oh no, he's just gonna finish him.
Or cowardice.
Stellar.
Another life wasted in the pursuit of glory and gold.
So we go first next. I don't see any way we're gonna win this. Yeah. No point keeping up with that. That was dead.
And fuel their frustration. Mop the blood and collect the teeth. Will you muster the metal to return?
So what I am noticing is that the abomination really gets focused. I'm wondering if there's anything we can really do to rectify that. Could go even more aggressive, but that takes away our accuracy. Snuff. No, we can't take an accuracy down. I don't see anything we can do.
The Ringmaster demands a challenger.
Let's continue a couple more times and gather more info. This is my first real foray into this rank, so I have no clue how hard this is gonna get, so. First, which means they get. Oh, it's this guy again.
The contest begins.
Let's get set up immediately.
Gnawing uncertainty, the birthplace of dread. The reveling throng demands its portion.
Do some damage. Also wondering if slamming Abomination isn't the right idea. I would like to go back to a more stun-focused Abom. Those are some of my favorite setups. But
act now.
Let's focus on the doctor.
They have a heal, they do high stress damage, and DOT is dangerous for us
because we don't have much of a healer. Probably gonna do lunge, don't care.
A dizzying blow to body and brain.
Yeah, lunging at the tank. Whatever. amazing. You have a 25% chance to crit. Yeah, I haven't seen a sniper shot crit in a long while. Really not feeling the quarrel. And now we're all stunned. Stress, it's fine. Double mark. Let's scare him. I can use Holy Lance, but Holy Lance doesn't matter to me. Cool. Oh, that was a stellar low roll. Really good. Fantastic. The bleed doesn't mean anything, so fair.
Perched at the very precipice of oblivion.
All right, we both get healed, so it's fine. Stunned, she can try and heal herself. What's she gonna do? Oh boy.
Oh yeah.
So now we have both of our mark dealers ready to take on the Vestal, so if the Crusader and the Plague Doctor go to try and save her, we can keep knocking her back down. And then only the Grave Robber will really be able to act. Oh. Oh, okay. Back to the old target. No stuns can be really done. Holy Lance. I really don't care.
Ringing ears.
Sure.
Congrats. Vision. The end approaches.
So I can still just do this.
A decisive pummeling.
Because there's nothing about the Plague Doctor being in two that really worries me. Probably gonna go for pick to the face.
A brilliant confluence of skill and purpose. This is no place for the weak or foolhardy. Fight on. The mob rallies to the underdog. The reveling throne demands its portion.
Yeah, these big constant healing teams are obnoxious because you just can't get Death Store. So I can do that, then guess what? Crusader and the Plague Doctor can do it all over again. So I can only keep prodding at them until they go insane. Yeah, battlefield medicine. Guess what I can do again?
The reveling throne demands its portion.
Would have been better earlier, now I think about it. Battlefield medicine can only be done up front.
Test.
Or up
fast.
Back. So if I pulled them earlier, they'd only have two heals to keep the Plague Doctor off with. See? So now all she can do is pick.
But it can be postponed.
Pick her Shadow Fade Knight. Okay. Neat. Damage does rank do? 8 to 14, sure.
A hand's breadth from becoming unwound.
I'm also gonna use Antiquarian. Arbalest to remove her stealth because these stats are scary. Yep. So, no. No stealth buffs. Doesn't matter. Fuck it. Just get up front. Now all I can do is incision, loser. Really trying to afflict them, but alright. Yeah, so something I'm gonna experiment with is that I think my issues come from. I'm finding that my issues come from the frontline abomination. Trying to slam on the first turn isn't helping. So I think I should spec away from move skill and spec more into the kind of stunning hybrid. Noxious Blast. Oh, incision. Okay. Doing that not only to get him off of Death's Door and away from a affliction, but I also want to give him the other two in the back more turns instead of using Arbalest to heal. I don't know what they're doing trying to spread the damage, but again, do that to keep them fucked up. Getting really bored of this fight. Man, this really just never crits. Especially when you're kind of specced into it. I sound bored, it's because I am. I find that these teams with like tons and tons of healing are just so boring to chop through. It's just tiring. Yeah, I'm not gonna bother. I don't wanna deal with this.
Feeding the evil therein.
Boring fight.
You deny the rabble their sport and fuel their frustration. Mop the blood and collect the teeth. Will you muster the mettle to return?
So, if I really want to be like an absolute asshole stunner, then, well,
sorry
to, everyone that has to deal with this, but, my wrath has been incurred. This, I'll have a 135% chance to stun. Well, the people I'm gonna stun aren't gonna have terribly high stun chances, so. Let me think, what's something we could pull off with this? We have a bunch of ranged skills and light. Can inflict a riposte if I think, I can riposte if I think people are gonna target me. It's like a defensive tactic. Absolution, it's absolution. Spec into something defensive. There, my issue is my movement. Then I can just start slamming. I'm also finding that it's the wrong idea to switch off Collect Bounty. That worked at first, but now it's not anymore. Dodge. Manticles is already 110 base accuracy, so extra accuracy isn't too important. Crushed Hemlock could be good if we do transform and use Rake, but it's not something we're really doing. Could use the Bugle or Treated Bandage to deal with, to help with our self-heal, and the extra dot resistances are nice. Bleeds are particularly common, but our bleed resistance is already so low. Rotting Trophy, I mean, it's okay. I would incentivize using Beast Bile though, which I'm not going to be using. to try out Treat Advantage. You know what, I will. And that'll also give us extra healing from Crusader and Arbalest. Let's do that. See how this goes.
The Ringmaster demands the challenger.
Extra obnoxious stun party. Hell yeah. Mixture, killer, and stressor. Damn it. Yeah, that was a 45% chance to work. Highwayman pops a Vendetta, I'll definitely stun him.
Dazed, reeling, about to break.
That's cool. Kill the Jester. Just completely destroy the finale idea. Well, they can already use finale and possibly get a kill on the bounty hunter. That'd be really fucking annoying. Alright, didn't change out the quarrel.
Quickly the tide turns.
Gracious.
A momentary abatement.
So up next, I'm probably gonna... Yeah.
Perched at the very precipice of oblivion.
Harry dagger. That isn't the kill dagger.
Teetering on the brink, facing the abyss.
Okay, so nobody has the kill trinket. Whatever. So there is no healing on this team. Fuck. Don't need accuracy, I said.
Another life wasted in the pursuit of glory and gold. Fight on. The mob rallies to the underdog.
Game.
Act now.
Oh, right. So now nobody has a really good chance of killing, so,
A hand's breadth from becoming.
All he can do is stun him and just try and chip away at him without our finisher. Because, we got crit twice into oblivion. Right. Mark. Death blow chance versus marked. Good. One for one. There's gonna be no trickery in regards to finale. In fact, he probably could have finale'd my abomination and got rid of him. That would have been scary. Crit. Let's try it. Hey, yes. She's probably gonna go for the lunge after the abomination. Fortunately, we know. Oh. Fuck. Shadow Fade, we're better off countering it. Just not even deal with it. Even though it's not gonna change anything, she's still gonna get the crit, but it's better. Plus, we got rid of the Bellow debuff. They're mixing up the damage, so it's harder for us to recover. Some DOT on him. Oh, right, we don't have that. Never mind. Yes, the retribution. So I guess now we just try to fuck off the grave robber. So I should I stun? No, because he can go and he has. No, he doesn't. Well, let's not get greedy. All right.
A momentary abatement. Demands its portion.
Play it safe. Let's not get greedy. Rampart. Doesn't matter to me at all. Life of the days.
The reveling throne demands its portion.
I want to take a riposte. Yes, they can't heal.
no place for the weak or the foolhardy.
Yeah, it'd be best to use her to heal because I don't really feel like sniper shotting the highwayman. But I am feeling more confident for our frontliners. Right, you told me, Scott. See you later. Alright, I can just slam. Anyways, I'm gonna use this move to trap. Okay. I was going to stun him so that the riposte didn't hurt me, but, you know, that's another way for that to go. Flashing daggers.
Death waits for the slightest lapse in concentration.
It's not the worst. This is a bit of a weird move because of... Fuck. Okay, so that wasn't worth it whatsoever. It was gonna be a risk move. Then this game was like, no. Alright, so that's not good. So now she can do another lunge. Which I do, in fact, hate. Flashing daggers. Should duel sometime. I think I got a good build for my team. Oh yeah, I'd loved it. Alright. Got fucked. Yeah, I'd love to duel Scott. Maybe even on stream one of these days, who knows. That and if they're left only one person, it's so hard to actually get a death blow, especially with their heals. So let's just try and kill the Grave Robber. Don't care.
A faint hope blossoms.
So now we can only just try and stun the highwayman.
The maniacal cheering swells. Victory
out
at hand.
Yeah, that last hero standing buffs, I don't think it's gonna help you, mate. Weird move, but fuck. Well, kinda locked into that one. Now let's do this because point blank shot is a higher death blow. Oh, right, and also. Haha, you can't punish me for my stupid mistakes. What you gonna do, bitch boy? Your riposte is out. Poor boy, he doesn't have his silly riposte. Fuck. Poor boy, he does not have his silly riposte. Now he's just gonna riposte next turn, which is still oh, never mind. Never mind.
Unnerved, unbalanced.
That's a nice dodge I got here. Can I have it?
Oh, that fucking sucks for him. Why is my accuracy 88? Oh lord, I need an accuracy trinket. Oh fucking hell. That isn't worth it. Oh my god. This person was so pissed.
Or cowardice.
This is the worst thing ever.
Surges as the enemy crumbles.
It's pretty cool.
The ringmaster is pleased.
Flagellant, plague doctor. All right. Wild bleeding. Attack, hit, self bleed. So it's just 15 accuracy and 15% damage. Yeah, the Crown of Thorns sucks. That looks terrible. Alright. Piercing Quarrel isn't working. Heal skills and prod. Really care about that. So now that I think about it, what else could place it? You know what? Sure. Ignore stealth, because I've been seeing a lot of grave robbers. Debuff chance if I want to use suppressing fire, and just basic accuracy. I think that's the plan. For you, that just isn't worth it. Yeah, Ring Eye Talisman. It's just 10 accuracy. I need that accuracy. That's fine. This is fine.
The Ringmaster demands a challenger.
Failed. Oh, let me check.
The rabble thrills to
it dropped no frame, so it definitely wasn't on my side. Oh no, this is the stupid generic opponents. These guys are terrible. Like, you see this? Parrying dagger? Oh, 10 damage and 3 crit. He doesn't have riposte. Oh, against marked. I'm sure there's a couple of marks. But he's just gonna use Come Hither. So this doesn't even give me prestige or anything. Or, well, it gives me prestige, but it doesn't give me any sort of, rank. So it's just a waste of time. Nice.
Well struck.
Ah, yes. I'm finally getting what I want. Versus a bot. Also, they don't properly heal or anything, so I can just do this and... Wow, my bounty hunter will just immediately kill them next turn, because they don't know anything about protection.
Mortality clarified.
Still, I'm gonna do it, because I want the points.
Press this advantage. Give them no quarter.
Welcome to the most boring thing in the universe.
As life ebbs, terrible vistas.
Wow, gee, I wonder when I'm going. Yes, use up that. That will help you.
Maintain the offensive.
Threatening. You want commentary? There is no commentary. This isn't a person. I fought this bot 3 times already.
And now, the true test. Hold fast, or expire.
But I also still get more points if I win, so... Not only win, lose nobody, so it's still worth trying. As bad as it feels.
A powerful blow.
Don't know what adding another mark will do, but you sure fucking did it.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all. The maniacal cheering swells. Victory is at hand.
Pain. Misery. Agony.
Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
We did it. Such an epic game, guys.
Master is pleased.
This may be the most boring trinket I've ever seen. I'd probably still use it. Alright, let's hopefully play this team against somebody who has a brain.
The Master demands a challenger. The rabble thrills to the spilling of blood.
right, this is the dodge team that agonized me. And they get the starting dodge.
Unsheathe your blades. The reveling throne demands its portion.
I want to stun the Houndmaster at first. Definitely want to kill the occultist, but I don't want him to start protecting or using Hound's Harry. Antiquarian wouldn't have been a bad idea with the invigorating vapors. Plus some melee skills. Why?
Such a terrible assault cannot be left unanswered.
No, let's get real greedy. Damn it. Well, I called it as it was.
Well, well, well. It would appear the buffoon is flummoxed.
Hail Mary, this is gonna miss. Yep. So that was a 43% chance to hit. There's not much I can do here. Well, Bello isn't bolster. Something. Okay, this is making me feel better.
Facing the abyss.
Oh, and he's stunned. Oh my god. We can actually pull out a really cheeky kill. Do not miss. It's a 78% chance. Thank you, the finisher. You did it. I won. Yay. Yay. I don't want you doing any more vapors.
Stress nuking, yeah.
Death waits for the slightest lapse in concentration. A hand's breadth from becoming unwound.
Something. Gonna protect. Start. Really putting his faith into the dodge. That was not only lucky to hit, but it also had a low chance of actually killing, so yeah. It is what it is. Get the fuck up here. You have a ton of dodge, which is annoying. But we can try. Did get accuracy trinkets for a reason.
Dazed, reeling,
great.
About to break.
face. Vapors. Stab. Two stress. Okay, calm down there, stress boy. Oh, that cleared it. I forgot it did that.
Yes.
Fortune is just gonna have to move back, but we did completely avoid that affliction. Move at the crew should also be a inspiring cry of the bounty hunter. I bet he's going to use burn. Well, oh, that's not the target I was thinking of, but sure. This means they don't really have the burst need. Where does Mark go? That's why I did that. Sure. Go for it anyways. Festering can get the affliction, so I'm just gonna do this now. Now what you gonna do? You gonna do a nervous stab, huh? It's gonna do a little bit of PP damage, huh? Huh? What you gonna do? Huh? Yeah, I thought so. I thought so. Fuck off. No heals. Especially no Stygian's Embrace.
Searched at the very precipice.
There's no direct heal, but only a protect that can be done. So that's good. So they got a affliction. Now they're gonna lose their second team member. Well, most likely. It's 50 dodge, but they also have the finisher, so. Oh, I don't like that chance. Hate it. For manticles. It's the highest accuracy. And I'll use this next turn to continue lowering stress. Probably use this turn next to get off a death door. Then all he has is vulnerability hex and Daemon's Pull. Stygian's Embrace if he's. Oh! Sorry about this, sweetie.
Festering fear consumes the mind.
Get fucked. You you can't defend yourself against me. I'm too cool. They've lost all the spark in their life, so this is the only thing they can do anymore. Is stress. And even then, I ain't gonna allow it. You know what? I'm gonna tease you.
Well struck.
Nancy Curry ain't even got crit. 33 rounds of bleed because of that crit. I bet you think you're real clever, mate. You're dying.
A dizzying blow to body and brain.
That's not good. Definitely should try a stun at the Antiquarian, even though it's probably gonna miss. Yep. Yeah, do another slop hit. It's consistent. So this is my life now.
The abyss returns even the boldest gaze.
Cool. What you gonna do, Defender? All right. This is a weird idea, but I just want to see what happens. Oh, right. I can't do that. Alright. Just basic damage time.
Injury and despondence set the stage for heroism.
Let's go for a...
Poor cowardice.
It's an affliction, but I'm gonna try for the stun. Fearful? Yeah, I don't care, mate.
Fear and frailty finally claim their due.
50-50 miss. Defender be defending. It won't for long, I can assure you that. The Legion can count on that. Oh no, wait, it will, because I'm gonna be knocked out. Well, yeah, one stress.
How quickly the tide turns.
It just stink crits. You know, in a way to, gonna do this so we don't, get immediately shot out, because I wanna keep him here so he stays in peace, so I can hit him with the, you know what, the slam. Unless this does him in. I think he just barely pulled through. Masochistic.
Those who covet injury find it in no short supply.
Fuck. Oh. It's stopped anyways. Alright. Cool.
And now the true test. Hold fast, or a Vox Bile.
This is just annoying. That's what this is. Alright. Yeah, it's a 50 dodge antiquarian. It sure is. What you gonna do?
Mortality clarified.
Does that crit every time? Is that what that trinket? She has 60. She has 60 dodge now. Get the fuck out.
Give them no quarter.
So if the crew acts, he's definitely going to have a heart attack. And so I'm gonna use the Arbalest.
As life
okay.
Ebbs,
Arbalest to prevent him from taking that horror. Themselves. The crit was incidental. No. No horror. No heart attack. Oh. That's a pretty epic one, Abomination. You just killed the... Yeah, she's gonna die of a heart attack. Stellar.
Confusion, nerves, and panic.
Fuck you, corpse. Here comes Prot Wars. It's probably death for him as well. It's good. You having fun yet? So I really don't want him having a heart attack, so I'm gonna keep buffing, or well, de-stressing. As it stands now, the Abomination is our key to success. Alright. If everything goes to plan, this man-at-arms has a 10% chance of living. Bye.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them.
So that's why I made an entire team to get rid of stress dealers, because they're really, really slow and boring. Anyways, I'm gonna be right back. I have to piss. I'll be back pretty much in like 30 seconds.
master demands a challenger. Rabble thrills to the spilling of blood.
PK. All right, Jester, looking to deal cons and DOT. A pushing DOT. So it seems like the one we're gonna wanna kill is the Jester, because they're really built for damage over time. And that's kind of this team's. That's kind of really scary for this team with no healer.
Chance is a fickle thing.
I don't like that they're going first. Let's see what they do and react.
Is broken. You have won.
Alright, that was a well earned fight. I worked incredibly hard for that one. As you can see from my skill, I lost nobody.
A cacophony of bloodthirsty delight.
And essentially I'm fucking cool. Did it.
Trinkets and trophies are yours to claim.
Don't really care about that. Huh. Kind of like highly accurate ranged approach to the Highwayman. Because most people like Wicked Hack, Bleed Out, stuff like that. Not Bleed Out,
The Ringmaster demands.
Yeah, whatever its skill is called. Be invisible.
Chance is a
the invisible manatee. I like that name.
The contest begins.
Okay. Stress. It's a stress team. And I joined the little Stygian's thing to make her invisible. Oh, plus 50% stressed up while stealth. No. The answer is no. I'm not dealing with that. Hey. Get rid of their stunner. That threatens me a lot. Isn't gonna have too much dodge, so immediately get rid of their healer. See, this is the kind of team that I really want to deal with. Because, if you can't tell, everything here is perfect for me. This guy can only bolster and defend. Or bellow, not bolster.
Knowing
what are you gonna do, slam me?
The birthplace of dread.
Oh. Okay. Well, if you don't mind, I'm going to try and take your occultist. He's stunned, so you can only protect him. But even then, guess what? That's not gonna save you either.
Oh no 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 no. Nuh-uh. Nope.
Festering fear.
Nope.
Consumes the mind.
Oh. Okay. I forgot that that didn't hit the third row.
That is fucked up.
Just scare the abomination.
Precision and power.
Damn. In fact, it did so little damage that it didn't even proc the death store. That's annoying. Yeah, my first option. Well, let's see what he does here. Yeah, he's gonna go for the heal, so I'm gonna go for the slam.
Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
So who's next? Probably gonna stun the Hellion, and then, yeah, Abomination. Kill them. Hello. Next. Prevent the Hellion from putting him onto Affliction. Also gets rid of Horror. They're stacking up some debuffs, so I'm also going to use Illuminating Flare.
As life ebbs, terrible vistas of emptiness reveal themselves.
Probably the right play, but still.
Fear and frailty finally claim their due.
Sorry.
Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Yeah, the stress is perfect to flick him, so rip.
Close in. The shadows whisper of conspiracy. A devastating blow.
Oh, I was lucky. And it's still got the crit, which is, no matter how you see it, it's still good. Get rid of all the debuffs. That actually helped me. Cool. And if he uses Defender, then I have another idea, which is gonna help me. Nah. So bear with me with this idea. I want to slam him to the backline.
Even the boldest gaze.
And you'll see why. Again, this is a really weird idea. And then I pull him. And now he's marked. And I can use sniper shot on him. That was the fucking 300 degree staircase idea of mine. Aren't they fucking cool? Strike. God, I am so cool.
And now the true test. Hold fast or expire.
Nice dodge.
The will to fight. Falters.
Yeah, that's annoying, but
I'm gonna have a rush here.
140 IQ.
Maybe a little.
Press this advantage. Give them no quarter.
Man, I'm so fucking cool.
The maniacal
God gamer. Swirls. God gamer.
Victory is at hand.
Man, I did a good play in fucking Darkest Dungeon multiplayer thing nobody cares about. Alright. Buffs. Oh, that also gets rid of the stun. Nice. I forgot about that. Okay. I was gonna do that on the abomination, but sure. To have a heart attack.
Teetering on the brink, facing the abyss.
Fuck it. Adrenaline rush. It's like 4 HP.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all. Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer.
Yeah, it is. A little. Yeah, a little bit.
Company of bloodthirsty delight. Praise well earned.
So that's the team when it's working at its fullest capacity. That's always what I'm trying to do.
take on Demon's Rams. My firms have been flummoxed.
The rabble thrills to the spilling of blood.
Stress Hound Master.
The advantage is yours.
Okay, so yeah, I wanna kill that boy in the back. Get over here. Finding the snuff does not help, because the fleshbound grimoire always just makes it like... Actually...
The horror.
Now she's in place. Oh, but now she can't sniper shot. Maybe I should've, did that on the occultist. Especially since they could guard the occultist. Get out. $50 on a Hellion. Oh yeah, there's two guards on this team. Well, that sucks. Yeah, 60 dodge, so it's not even worth going after the hand.
How quickly the tide
Unlucky.
Turns.
Again, I know what I want. No. Unlucky. Very unlucky, actually. Oh well. Just want to see what they do. Heal. Yeah. They could make this a little bit harder on me, but...
The reveling throne demands its portion.
Ultimately, I just don't want him stressing. you're trying to do. No.
The blood quickens.
Guards instead. Well, may have hit an affliction, but well, it's one affliction for somebody else. Oh, two.
Fury.
Stellar.
More destructive than 100 cannons. Confidence surges as
all right. Well, that's
crumbles.
The healer down. Up next is the hound. Coming for your ass. That's annoying. Oh! Oh, right, because I buffed it.
A moment of
yes!
Shines brightest against the backdrop of despair.
And let's remove all the debuffs. Get us back into speed. Oh. Okay. Okay. Let's see how it is.
Such a terrible assault cannot be left unanswered.
To happen next turn. Of course, oh. Oh, right! Because look at her accuracy. That's a top priority. Get rid of that shit. Just don't skip your turn this time. There, now our accuracy is fixed. Our damage is back to ground zero. Whoopee!
Injury and despondence.
No.
Set the stage for heroism.
Get out.
Or cowardice.
Dodge.
The reveling throng demands its portion.
Don't know what he can really do here, so I'm just gonna heal. Get some cheeky damage on the Hellion, but it's not gonna drop her to death's door. Although, actually, pushing her upward would fuck up her yop. Yeah, I should have considered that. But first off, I have a vendetta.
A hand's breadth from becoming
so now he's
wound.
Forced to use lick wounds. Use this moment.
Gnawing uncertainty.
The fuck off. No more yapping. This guy can't even lick his wounds.
Mm.
masterfully executed.
Scare the Hellion. Exactly. So now they aren't stressing us out.
Perched at the very precipice of oblivion.
Now the Houndmaster. All right, they just have to act. I forgot that even existed.
As life ebbs, terrible vistas of emptiness reveal themselves.
So now they're gonna have a heart attack and not get completely fucked.
Teetering on the brink,
God,
facing
annoying.
The abyss.
Our last act of Suicune aside is Illuminate. There.
Okay.
Mortality Good. Clarified in a single strike.
Oh, that's real nice. Ow.
And now the true test. Hold fast or expire.
Oh, that's not good. Breakthrough.
Another life wasted in the pursuit of glory.
And that's how luck affects the game. That was two 75% check. My bounty hunter killed himself. So that's why stress teams suck.
Mop the blood and collect the teeth. Will you muster the metal to return?
I don't want that game. I'm doing fine, thank you. So yeah, that was just an insanely unlucky ending. He chose the hit himself option at the worst time and passed the 75% check. And the two frontliners got hit with the 75% check and just died. No wait, he was the last man standing. That was a 15% chance kill. And he killed himself. So, yeah.
Let's get
going. The Ringmaster demands a challenger.
rabble thrills to the spilling of blood.
Oh, great. And I get the shitty robot again. I think the game's telling me to stop. Yep. This again.
The advantage is yours.
No.
Sheathe your blades. Mop the blood and collect the teeth. Will you muster the metal to return?
Fortunately, because I was a bot, I don't lose any rank or anything. I just chose to know that sounds painfully boring to deal with.
The rabble thrills to the spilling of blood.
Stressed how I advanced. Yeah, this is another stress team.
Unsheathe your blades.
As usual, I want to absolutely annihilate the healer.
Impressive.
Probably next. I should focus more on just stunning the Hellion when I can, so that they're incredibly obnoxious. This is a bleed everyone out and then stress them out. Everything here is stress.
The reveling throne demands its portion.
First off, no weakening curse. None. Now it's just the two supports in the back. Well, something like that.
To a killing blow.
And so these are all the people that will get really, really fucked by everyone else.
Teetering on the brink, facing the abyss.
Oh wait, this person went last. Oh, we already took out the occultist. That's beautiful. Oh, it's 40. I hope that we have this.
Formation is broken. Maintain
all right.
Offensive.
Up next, fuck the Houndmaster. Yeah, yeah, Bello. Quit your yapping, puffer. There's nothing. Nothing. Oh wait, the accuracy, yeah. I don't really feel like doing damage right now, so I'm going to play safe and get rid of the accuracy debuffs. We need the consistency. Dogs. So I wonder if I should replace suppressive fire with Theramark because it decreases dodge. these stress combos are really frustrating. Because Hound's Harry to bleed everyone really high, then having this chick have the stress dealt is just so aggravating. That's pretty nice though.
Who covered injury find it in
Sweet.
No short supply.
Alright, because the frontliners are gonna be useless up. Otherwise, we gotta get rid of the accuracy debuffs. We can take the negative damage though. Sniper. Thanks for giving me an excuse, man. Fuck. This person doesn't have lick wounds, so once they're down, they are helpless. Let's do exactly that.
A hand's breadth from becoming unwound.
So that's all afflictions. Even with the team made for murder, we can't outrace the stress.
Continue the onslaught.
But I can still kill them so they don't have the full momentum of a four-man team. And the other team being completely afflicted. Took two casualties to get here. Anyways, so I can push her into range. He chose to, okay. I was gonna... What I was gonna do is slam the Hellion back so he can bully her easier with the Bounty Hunter and Arbalest, but you know, some things aren't meant to be. No, I'm not even gonna bother with dealing with the stress. Fuck. That's what happens if when I don't bother with the stress, you miss, because my accuracy no.
Gnawing uncertainty.
All right, now she's pretty much dead.
Thank you.
charge. Give them no quarter.
So now it's just old man screams at Eldritch Abomination, Knight, Edgelord, and Black Woman. Actually, this is a pretty apt description of America right now. Old white man versus the world.
Okay. No help then.
Precision and power.
Should have used the Houndmaster Mark attack. Make them naked and afraid. Okay, Scott, calm down. Swap back. And I'll try and stun. Okay. That's all I want to do right now, stop him from fucking bellowing. He's going, and it's annoying. Also, this is one of those times where I wanted that 20 armor pierce, but it's not gonna happen.
Diminished.
Alright. Welcome to I refuse to die, but also it's impossible for me to win. Yay. Alright, I could also use the spike chain to bleed him out, or blight him out. It's kind of funny. It's not gonna hit the riposte, but it's something. Okay. Yep. Oh, it also, he's afflicted.
Reeling, gasping, taken over the edge into madness.
Alright. Sure showed me. Alright. Yarg. This person's fucking resilient. I would've just gave up already. This is so boring. Okay. Help me, Squirtle, I'm dying. Is that what we like to call a GG?
Fast or expire.
As
the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
The ultimate disrespect. The fucking afflicted attack. Kill them.
A new league.
I did it.
A
I'm veteran.
Craven adversaries.
I deserve that. Alright. I think I've pooped myself out from all the fucking stress teams. That actually got so monotonous to deal with, but I like this team. I think it's working out well for me. But I've grown bored, and when I grow bored, I stop streaming. So, thank you for watching, everyone, and I'll see you, honestly, probably in the next few days. It's one of those games I can just pick up fucking, like, daily, play it on stream. So, ta-ta, goodbye.